Hi, my name is Graham Walker. I work for Allied Telesis as a product manager. And today I would like to demonstrate to you a cool feature of Allied Telesis Management Framework, or AMF. And that feature is the ability to auto-recover from a failed piece of hardware with zero touch. So AMF will automatically reconfigure the new device to be the exact copy of the old device. So for the purposes of the demonstration, I have some equipment in front of me here. This device here, the Switchblade X908, is my AMF master. It will be in charge of pushing down the configurations. This device at the bottom is the X510, which is actually running the video stream that you can see on the two monitors in front of me. It's the device that I'm going to simulate a failure on. And the device at the top is going to be my spare device. So it's completely unconfigured at the moment. It's factory default. I have it running just to save a little bit of time, but it's not doing anything right at this moment. This screen here simulates displays the video source, so that's going to continue to run. And this screen here shows the video client, so you'll see that stop while the network is broken. And then when the AMF master reconfigures this device and this device reboots, you'll see that will start again automatically. So I won't need to reconfigure this new device at all. AMF will do all that for me. So to start the demonstration, what I'm going to do is power off the bottom device to simulate a network failure. And at that point, you'll see this video stop. And then I'm going to all I have to do at that point is move the cables from the old device to the new device. And as soon as I move that red cable, the AMF cable, the cable from the AMF master here, onto the new device, AMF will take over and start to reconfigure this device. So let me start that right now. So if I pull the power on this first device, that video has stopped. And all I need to do now is move these video cables. So that's the video client cable, video source cable. Video still hasn't restarted because this device has no configuration on it. And as soon as I move this AMF cable over to the new device, the X510 spare, you'll see that on the console window, you'll see that this device has already begun to talk to the AMF master, and the master has begun to push down the configuration files. So the AMF master has detected that this device has taken the place of the old device, the device that's just failed. The AMF master realizes that, and instead of just bringing it up as a clean unit, as it would do normally, it's detected that what we're trying to do is recover from a failure. So it is going to take the configuration files from this old unit and push them onto the new unit. I'm not going to have to do anything. And in just a couple of minutes, that video will restart automatically. So what AMF is doing, or how AMF manages these backups, the AMF master, once every 24 hours by default, it will reach out to all the AMF nodes on the network, and it will pull the latest configuration files and even the latest firmware files and store them on the memory card. So we have an SD card at the front of this X908, and that's where it stores all the configuration files and release files for all the nodes on the network. So as a network administrator, you don't have to worry about managing your own library of configuration files and making sure that everything's up to date. And if somebody's changed something, then you have to make sure that that gets synchronized into your library. AMF does all that for you. So by default, once a day, it will copy those files. You can also kick off a backup at any time if you want as well. So you can make a change to configuration, and then you can tell AMF to back that configuration up for you. So as soon as you have a device failure, you can be sure that the configuration will be the latest configuration that gets pushed onto your spare device. So we see this as a really useful feature for scenarios where you have edge units that are maybe out in remote locations away from the IT center. Maybe in a school would be an example. you have a switch in a classroom, the switch fails for some reason, and the school teacher wants to be able to recover his network. Rather than having to phone the IS department or phone his third-party managed services provider, he simply gets on the phone to his management centre, and they say, hey look, all you need to do is get the spare unit, cable it up, put the red cable in port one, that's the AMF cable, and power it on. Now I had it already powered on just to save a little bit of time, but normally you wouldn't have the device powered on. And what will happen is AMF will push the configuration down to the file and the video should restart automatically. I believe that that video has just restarted, proving that AMF has fully reconfigured this device. It's taken over as the previous device, and I've had to do no configuration at all. I'm no network engineer, I'm just a product manager. If I can do it, anyone can do it, trust me. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the demonstration. Please check out our Allied Telesis YouTube channel for other videos, and remember that AMF is available on Switchblade and X-Series switches. Thank you.